looks dead.
Oh, he's popping.
All right, so what is going on, everybody? Orbear back with another Valorant video. And in today's video, I want to talk about something that really grinds my gears. There's so much talk on the internet about people not liking the aesthetic of Valorant. They're saying it looks like a kid's game, it looks too cartoonish, and why can't we have better graphics for a game released in 2020? Now, if you don't like an aesthetic of a game, I get it. We all like different things. Some people play Escape from Tarkov and they love kind of the, I don't know what you want to call it, photo realistic quality. There's so much detail in the image from Escape from Tarkov in contrast to how, well, dumbed down or cartoonish it is in Valorant. So in this video, I want to talk about why I really like the fact that Valorant is cartoonish and why I think they went for this look in the first place. So the first point that comes to mind is the fact that a clear view makes it easier to spot enemies. Now, it doesn't come as a shocker when you have less foliage on the walls, when you have less clutter items that are in the way, you have an easier time to spot enemies. So when you swing around a corner, the moment you see a pixel change, that's most likely an enemy. Whereas in certain games like Escape from Tarkov to, you know, obviously very drastic, super realistic game, you have so much foliage and so much extra stuff, it's really, really hard to spot the enemy players. And of course, in Valorant, you even have their little red outline around the characters because they want you to spot the enemies. It should be as easy as possible to spot somebody that you're going to take down. And I like that approach. It brings me back to Counter-Strike 1.6, where everything is, you know, in terms of graphics, very dumbed down, but for me, it's never been about the look. Now, I can appreciate games like Tarkov, I can appreciate games like Warzone and other games that are more realistic looking, but at my core, at my heart, when I'm thinking competitive, I want it to be as easy as possible to spot these enemy players. And in this game, you have a clear view, meaning it's easier to spot your enemies. And just a final note on that as well, like most decals and items that they have in the game are well above where you would see a normal player. So if you look at a wall, kind of the upper half of that wall, that's where they keep the decals, maybe a window, maybe a lamp. Everything else is very clean and neat. Now, going from the clear view, we're transitioning into the next point I want to make, and that is the sharp lines. Once again, very close to my heart when it comes to Counter-Strike 1.6, where, you know, the walls are very sharp. There's not stuff sticking out from the walls or walls that are curving in a weird way. It's very straight lines, so you know that if you see somebody, you can shoot this person. Whereas in other games, maybe that wall bends a little bit and that causes an invisible hitbox that you can't get around unless you strafe well around the mountainside or whatever it might be that you're trying to shoot somebody through. With this game, sharp lines, if you see somebody, you can take this player out right away. Now, the third and final point I want to home in on is the fact that performance takes a big hit when you add extra stuff into the game. The more stuff you have to render, the more stuff you have to look at when you're gaming, the more resources your computer is going to need to project all these things. Now, with a very bare bones approach to the looks of a game, you're able to escape with some ridiculously low specs that are needed for whether it's the minimum, the recommended, or the high end. Now, I'm going to pull up a picture so you can actually see for yourselves what the recommended specs are, the minimum, the high, etc. And you can clearly tell that this game can essentially run on a toaster. You don't need a lot of horsepower to get this game running, and that's why you're going to have a game that has a much wider reach than some of the other games. I mean, look at League of Legends. That can also be run on essentially any laptop, any computer. Now, you and I might have a good high-end gaming PC, but not everybody does. So appealing to a larger audience can never be a bad thing. It's going to bring in more players, more eyeballs on the scene, meaning the game is going to get more publicity, more hype, more money put into it. We're talking tournaments. The potential for this game is so huge, and I think you guys are really, really going to enjoy it. Obviously, some of you guys are already into the closed beta. Some of you guys are patiently waiting waiting for you to get access, but when you guys play it, you will see that this is something, this is a game that's going to be here for a long time. But on that note, guys, I will wrap up today's video, but those are my opinions and thoughts on why I think it's good that Valorant is cartoonish to the look. Now, listen, we all like different. You may not agree with me, and that's totally fine. Let me know in the comment section down below, does it still bother you that Valorant is cartoonish to the look? Do you guys agree with me? Do you disagree with me? Let me know in the comment section down below, but without further ado, that will be everything. So like up the video, leave your comments down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next video later. Bye-bye. Yeah.